And now, from Austin, Texas, the live music capital of the world, it's the Bling Johnson Show. Tonight's musical guest is ZZ Top. The house band is Lucas Cook and The Collection. Security provided by Bubba Incorporated. And now, from the backyard in Austin, Texas, a man that'll never be as famous as Charlie the Unicorn, Bling Johnson!
And welcome to the Bling Johnson Show. We are back here in Austin, Texas at the backyard, and we're here with a very special friend, Mr. Carl Stubner. How you doing?
I'm feeling pretty good. Very excited about tonight.
Now, many of you may not know, but we are here
no
for...
No one knows.
That's the beauty of my life. No one knows.
Well, guess what? You may be able to go to the grocery store unnoticed, but we're going to tell everybody. This guy in the music industry is a big deal. We're here for ZZ Top tonight. He manages ZZ Top, but he's also managed some pretty important bands. Motley Crue, Fleetwood Mac, Poison. Who else?
Can't remember. Alanis Morissette, Seal, Whitesnake, Andrew Dice Clay, my favorite.
Andrew Dice Clay. So we're covering the gamut. So if you're in the music business, a high, really good chance you know who this guy is. So we're here at the backyard in Austin, Texas for ZZ Top. And we got a lot of really exciting things. We got an interview with Mr. Billy Gibbons. Thank you for hooking that up. This is the guy that made that happen.
I know, but we're in local turf here, and he wants to do everything he can in local turf. So
That's right.
It's all good.
Now, hey, now you've traveled the world. You've worked with the biggest names in the music business, rock and roll. How does it feel to finally achieve a level of success that allows you to have a conversation with Bling Johnson?
Well, you know, when Bling interviews you, and I will talk to you in the third person or whatever we say.
Yeah, it's kind of the fourth because it's
fourth, I guess. Yes, because that would be you'd be fourth. But the Bling, to be a part of any interview with the Bling is crucial to the success of all my artists.
Can I use that as just a standalone clip on TV?
Clearly.
We got a new infomercial, everybody. Biketoberfest 2012 in Daytona Beach, and you're a familiar face from Bike Week, right?
Yes, Kiki from Main Street Station.
That's right. Now, how did you feel to be on the Bling Johnson Show last March?
I had a blast. I actually went on the website and watched it and everything.
Did you really?
I told a lot of people about it, so it was awesome. Thank you.
All right. Well, hey, it got bigger this year. We are actually in Houston and Austin now, so we're glad to have you on the show. Welcome to Daytona Beach. We're here at Biketoberfest, one of the biggest. Apparently, nobody knows. Oh, yeah. Hey, don't worry about it. Hey, we're just filming a show. So we're at Biketoberfest. You having a good time?
I'm having a blast. It's awesome this year.
This is a little bit crazy out here tonight, isn't it?
It's crazy, but the weather is good. We had a little bit of rain, but it's a good turnout. We had a blast. I'm having a blast.
It is. Well, if this is any indication, last time we had so many crazy people on the show. So we're going to go ahead and head out on Main Street and see who we can find. What do you think about that?
Awesome. Do it. Clutch it up.
Hey, thanks for being on the show again. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
I'll tell you, man, there is nothing like Biketoberfest. What are you laughing at? I didn't even say anything yet. What are you laughing for?
I'm just happy.
Is that because you grabbed me?
Yeah.
This is a pretty enjoyable night for me. How about you? Got lost for words now. Hey, where do y'all live?
Deltona.
I mean, like, what's your address? Hang on. Right here. Here we go. Look at the camera. What's your name? Having a hard time here. Whoa, hey, how you doing? Okay, there you go.
Yeah, my name is Jennifer, man.
It is.
Look, this is Bike Week 2012.
Oh, yeah.
This is the way it's going to go.
Where y'all from?
St. Augustine.
Oh, Oh, St. Augustine, you didn't have to come too
Venezuela.
Far.
Yeah.
Venezuela.
Yeah.
You habla español?
Claro.
Ah, mi familia vive en la playa en San Juan, Puerto Rico.
In Puerto Rico.
Sí. Yeah. They really don't. That's just the only thing I know how to say in Spanish. So here we are. Let me introduce you to one of my best friends, closest friends for an extremely long time, my buddy Riley. How you doing, man?
Terrific, Bling. Awesome, awesome.
All right, so hey, is this your first time on television? You had to be on TV before.
It is, except for in high school.
Well, what'd you do there?
That was junior achievement.
Oh, well.
We don't talk about that.
We don't achieve much on this show. So, hey, what I wanted to do is tell everybody who Riley was. Riley is one of my great friends, and I actually bought my Harley from you.
That is true.
And not only did you sell it to me, but you held a note, which is the only way that was possible.
Well, and in fact, that's the second time we've done that.
That's the second bike I bought from you. That's right.
Right, and I just bought your third bike.
Yeah, so he just bought a new one, and so we figure in about, 5-6 years, I'll be buying that one again.
Exactly, exactly.
Y'all big into the whole social media thing or what?
Yes.
Yeah, you got the internet and stuff at home? They got internet in Deltona?
Yeah, we have it.
What about Facebook?
Yeah, we have that.
All right, search for Bling Johnson on Facebook. That's me. You got to find me.
What about my shirt?
Well, find me, then send me your address off camera, and I will send you a shirt.
All right.
Okay.
You'll do it. What's my name?
Bling.
Who?
Bling.
You don't even know what my name is.
That's how it goes, baby.
Hold on, I got a question for you. I got a very important... Oh, sorry, hold on. Let's try to stay upright. You're stumbling around a little bit. You having a hard time this evening? You having a good time?
Yeah, I'm having a hard time getting it. Man.
She's a bad example.
A bad example? Well, hey, you're doing a great job. The children of America, thank you. I'm just messing with you. You having a good time?
Buddy, you know what?
Don't punch me. Please don't punch me. I love you. We all love you.
Head.
No, we don't want that. We don't want that.
I don't even want damn Chinline News to be handling this.
Baby girl,
you might cut the Chinline News off real quick.
Hold on.
Pow!
Is this a joint interview?
Yes, this is the reason we do this show is what this is called.
Oh, is it?
Well, yeah, it is now.
Oh, great.
So how are y'all doing tonight?
We're doing great. Getting started, ready for some drinks. I'm Samantha.
You're Samantha.
My girlfriend, Michelle.
Well, that's great. Well, great to meet you. I'm Bling Johnson. Have you ever heard of our show?
I actually have not. I'm sorry.
You just act like you have, and I can edit that in.
Well,
have you ever heard of the Bling Johnson show?
I have heard of it so much. Yes, I love you, Bling Johnson.
All right, hey, how you doing, man?
All right, mate. You?
What's up with the accent, man? Where are you from?
Australia.
I thought you worked at Outback Steakhouse or something.
You.
Hey, don't kill me. Don't kill me.
Right.
I've been watching Sons of Anarchy. I don't really want to get shanked right about now. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying.
I have a feeling I know what you're saying. Hey, I got one question for you. If you had to rate yourself a 1 to 10, 10 being very drunk and 1 being not drunk at all, what would you say you are?
I would say I'd be very to 10, you'd being be a, very characteristic and very really? Being good to go.
Well, hey, we're happy that you're on our show. Thank you very much. So a lot of you have been watching what's been going on my website lately. I wrote a blog recently about getting close to the Lord, and lo and behold, Jesus walks by.
Here I am.
However, I had no idea you were a fan of Jack Daniels.
I love this stuff. You know what? I'm going to go get in about another 4 shots of that, get tuned in, right, and then cruise around and see if I can find...
Well, it's clearly a case of mistaken identity then. I thought you were my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, apparently not quite.
I am not the one.
Okay.
The one.
Well, hey, thanks for stopping by anyway.
Hope you find him someday.
Yeah, I sure need to, really quick. All right, so we don't know when this is going to air. This is either going to be before or after the election, so you're going to look really smart or like on the losing side. I don't know which one.
All right, we're smart.
Hey, where are you from?
France.
France?
So
kind of what's the point of you holding your signs in?
I'm just giving votes, you know, telling people what to do.
America.
Advising people.
You're from France here advising us on who our president should be.
You know.
Because, I mean, you guys clearly have it figured out over there, you know?
We did.
Hey, what's up with all the French fries and bad attitudes?
Huh?
The French people. Everybody has a bad attitude. That's French, don't they?
Are you insulting me right now?
No, you actually seem like a contrary to that. You seem very nice.
So you seem?
I'm surprised. That's why.
Exactly. So all French people are not like...
All right. So tell America, why should they vote for Romney?
A change in America. We cannot afford 4 more years like that, you know?
Wait, hold on. Why are you saying we?
Oh, because...
Man, this is the best interview I've ever had. Thanks, guys, for coming on. We appreciate it.
Yeah.
Right.
America.
Hey, what's the craziest thing you guys have seen out here this week?
This week, it had to be her flashing the bartender.
Really?
Other than that...
Hold on.
Other than that...
did you really flash a bartender?
I did.
Really? Was that unprovoked? Or
in our room or out of our room?
See,
craziest in our room or out of our room?
Did the bartender come into your room?
No.
No.
So just her and I.
Our room was strictly me and her.
Like it, like you and her, or like just you and her?
Like me and her.
Like
it's like that?
Yeah.
I love you guys. Yeah. Is that bad?
Bling, we love you.
All right. Hey, thanks for being on the show.
We're a huge fan.
I really, all I want to do is drag this interview out as long as possible.
Hey,
if you don't mind.
Very in-depth political interview, if you ask me.
I asked a hard-hitting question.
That was very hard-hitting.
That's right.
That was extremely political and extremely hard-hitting.
Now I'm looking to pick up a biker now.
So now you're looking to pick up a biker?
Yeah.
Would you like me to help you with that?
No, I don't know about that.
Why? Are you thinking?
I'm Republican. I have very distinctive tastes.
You're at a biker rally. I really, I'm not giving you.
I saw a few.
You did?
Oh, yeah.
Here, look at this guy coming in the orange right here. Look at this guy.
No.
No, that's not
I'll
it.
I'll go with you.
You'll go with me?
You got
it. Where you, really, where you want to go?
Right now, I'm going to Froggies.
Froggies? So me and you are going to Froggies? Is that what's going down?
Would you like to?
I don't know. My available credit's kind of tapped out right about now.
Don't you have to stay here and do this for a little
while? I kind of do.
Okay.
But hey, I guess the hope that we had something gave me comfort.
Okay. What time you get off?
Well, depends on what I'm watching. But hey, anyway, hey, thanks for a lot for coming on the show.
Low-carb, low-sugar, delicious cocktail that I've been making for 30 years. There's nothing conventional or traditional about me, and certainly not my product.
You're probably environmentally conscious and already doing things like separating your recycled plastics from your garbage. But do you know what happens to those recyclable items once you've done your part? Currently, more recycled plastic is collected than can be used. Many times, the recycled plastic that's collected ends up back in landfills and the waste stream because there's not enough demand. Reflex Packaging has developed cushions to protect sensitive items during shipping using recycled plastic. Environmentally conscious companies are already using this packaging, like Taylor Guitar and Seagate, to reduce their carbon footprint. For more information, find us on Facebook and visit reflexpackaging.com.
Limited mobility doesn't mean limited options. Providing solutions for life, the dealership of choice is Austin Mobility Solutions. We offer the largest inventory of new and pre-owned Honda, Chrysler, and Dodge mobility vans in Central Texas. Industry-leading mobility solutions from Bruno, Gosici, and we're the number one VMI dealer in the U.S. For sales and 24-hour service, visit Austin Mobility Solutions at I-35 exit 248 in Pflugerville or austinmobility.com.
And welcome back to the backyard here in Austin, Texas. Now, my next interview, I've been doing this show for a year on TV. We've been on the internet for 3 years. And I got to tell you, this day was probably the coolest day I've ever had from doing the show. We got Mr. Billy Gibbons, the main guitar guy and lead singer for ZZ Top, to sit down with me. And this is different than just a little short interview. He sat down with me for 30 minutes and had a conversation. And we talked about everything from the new CD, La Futura, all the way to the music video for Gots to Get Paid. And you know what? This is going to be a little extended interview because I just think this guy's a legend in rock and roll and deserves the time. And we just had a great talk. So let me throw it over backstage here to one of the little cabins in the back of the backyard with me and Mr. Billy F. Gibbons. And welcome back. We are backstage at the backyard here in Austin, Texas, with one of the legends of rock and roll, Mr. Billy F. Gibbons from ZZ Top. How you doing, man?
Well, we're doing fine. We're doing fine. I know it's fine because you and I can talk about our favorite stuff.
That's exactly right. We have a good idea what some of that is. I got to tell you, I've been doing this show for a year on TV and about 3 years on the internet.
And this is one of the most exciting moments of my life, sitting here with you.
Well, that's a distinct honor because we follow you quite regularly. I guess as we sit here at the backyard, as you pointed out, this is the second annual ZZ Top's LaGrange Festival. And for all of your fans, friends, and followers, as much as we'd like to know, we'd like to answer the question, or have it answered, have we all gotten famous yet?
Well, I'll tell you what, man, I'm well on my way. You keep doing shows like this with me and hanging out, man, I think I'll get there. You clearly have been there, man. You guys have been all over the place. I follow you a lot, you and Dusty on Facebook and Twitter and all that. The tour has just been grueling. You guys have been all over the place.
It's been real rewarding, the release of the new ZZ Top disc, La Futura. The first disc to come along since our release of Mescalero, which was now, it took 9 years between, seems to be popping pretty good. And the good news is, it's kept us busy.
Well, let's talk about the CD for a second, because that's the first one that you guys have put out in quite some time. And I was watching the Rolling Stone video interview that was done with you, talking about, you know, why it took so long. Answer to our fans here, you know, why did it take a little bit of extra time? Because I know you guys had a lot that went into it to make it so good.
Well, the ramp up was the good part. As many suspicions were trying to figure out, well, we heard ZZ Top's got a new record out, it's going to possibly work with Rick Rubin. And after 2 years go by, it's like the coming of Chinese democracy. Is it ever going to happen? The better part of that story is spotlighting our buddy Rick Rubin, who has this immense measure of patience. Rick is in no big hurry.
I heard Kid Rock talking about that when he produced his Born Free album.
Oh, yeah. Everybody that has the opportunity to work with Rick soon discovers that there's no big rush. Now, some artists may get a little bit frustrated saying, well, isn't it done? Isn't it complete? We turned it in quite a while back. But Rick is not ready to proceed until that sense of intuition resonates, and he said, okay, we can move forward. We enjoy, as a band, ZZ Top's favorite thing is getting to play. And when Rick said, okay, could we play it again? Well, we couldn't have been happier. So it worked out really good, and the momentum over time became a series of really fun late-night jam sessions that kept on going.
So one of the latest songs to come out of that CD is Gots to Get Paid, and it's just a cool jam. It's amazing how after so many years of doing music, you guys still put out something that still has that cool factor. And the video, which we're actually going to show you a little bit of right now, has a lot of really cool cars. Obviously, we're big fans of, you know, Austin Speed Shop, and I know SoCal, you know those guys over there, and a lot of cool stuff. Tell us about the song, and tell us a little bit about the video.
Well, it was the last entry that was delivered. And I was talking with Rick, and we were scratching our heads trying to think of how to round out this package. And the incongruous coupling of ZZ Top meets Houston hip hop and rap was kind of the unexpected surprise when we re-aimed it toward blues and rock. It just so happened I was in the studio with Mr. Joe Hardy and Mr. GLG Main Moon, right down there in Houston at Foam Box Recordings. Mr. Moon happened to be watching some old Lightnin' Hopkins videos, and Joe and I were talking about how the song 25 Lighters had lingered in my brain for 15 years. And the next thing, we had a nice backbeat going on, and we just kind of dragged it over by way of Lightnin' Hopkins steering it. And the legitimizing factor, it's both kind of an homage to the Houston ghetto. It all came out of the same thing.
There's something else that you're involved with, too, which is a tequila. Can you tell us a little bit about that tequila? Because there may be a few of our fans that enjoy the tequila quite a bit, and or even a little bit. Tell us about that.
Yeah, Pura Vida Tequila. which is now offering four different expressions, silver, gold, añejo, and ultra. And it's picking up steam. A good buddy of mine, Stuart Skloss, who I've known forever, approached me about 5 years ago, and he said, I want to know if you'd be willing to get involved in a little thing I've got going. I said, well, what little thing might that be? He said, well, I want you to help me get into the launching of a new tequila. And I said, well, Stuart, funny thing about me and tequila, I said, I don't think that I've tried it since I was about 20. I said, I remember one night I had to turn my back on tequila because it turned its back on me. But the good news, I said, if you can get something in a bottle that's palatable, and if you think that you can make it go, then 3 years went by, and he called me up, and he says, well, I think I've met your challenge. Took a sip, and we were there.
Well, good, Dad. Some great stuff. Be sure to get out there. Try it. Get the new CD. It's available in stores everywhere, online, iTunes. It's everywhere. And I got to tell you, thank you very much for taking the time to talk to me. For somebody that's just starting a new show and kind of getting out there in the entertainment business, this is huge for me. And the fact that you guys would take the time really means a lot, and I appreciate it.
ZZ Top, thanks you. I thank you. And as a reminder, let's get famous.
Hey, what else we got to do, right?
That's it.
Called it the most innovative radio station in the country. Austin just called it Coke FM. It invented the progressive country music format and started the careers of some of today's biggest stars. The radio station that started it all, Coke FM, is back on the Austin airwaves at 99.3 and 98.5, or worldwide at CokeFM.com. Austin's country alternative, K-O-K-E FM. Proud to be back in the heart of Texas and taking country music back. Coke FM, 99.3 and 98.5, CokeFM.com.
Go for something new. Some of y'all seen the video that got that stuff in it. You know I got to get paid. Yeah. Come on. Yes, sir. You know I got to get paid. I got 25 riders on my dresser. Yes, sir. You know I got to get paid. Big time 9-9 easy come and I'm 25 doors.
Guy's a big TV star, and he stands up to get a picture with her. Me, he sits down. What's up with that, man? Hey, I know you've done a lot of things in your life, and you're kind of a big deal, but how does it feel to finally be on the Bling Johnson show?
I feel like I made it.
You know what? You did. You excited to ride next to me?
Yeah.
Hey, do you want to ride on the back of my bike for part of the time?
No, I'm not so sure about it. I mean, you're handsome and all, but...